how I earned $50,000 in just one single month from live streaming, and why this number isn't all too far off for someone who simply just doesn't know what to charge. Hey there, viewer, my name is Zephan Moses Blacksburg, and if you haven't heard of me or you're new to the channel, welcome. Please hit that subscribe button below and leave me a comment to let me know where you're watching from. I read all of them. I'm a videographer and owner of ZMB Media located in Maryland in the good old US of A. I've been creating videos professionally for 11 years now and had my own business for 8 of those. If that opening caught you off guard, trust me, when I saw those numbers, it freaked me out too. I'm not here to brag though, I'm here to share with you what made that possible, and at the end of this video, I'll share one way that you can work with me to raise your prices and put yourself on the path to success. So let's dive into a breakdown of the $50,000 month. I'll share briefly how that happened, the average pricing for my projects, and what I think attributed to the huge jump in profits. Let's begin with how a $50,000 month happened. I've been filming professionally for 11 years. So, as you can imagine, my prices have gotten better over time. When I first started, I charged $25 an hour, but I was living under my parents' roof and certainly couldn't afford to live on my own. One of the biggest changes that I made was I hired a business coach that was trusted by so many of my peers. And the one lesson that she taught me was to keep doubling my prices. So the next client came along and it went to $50 an hour. Then the next, it was $100 an hour. Eventually, I settled in around $200 per hour and found that to be the upper limit of what my higher-end clients were willing to pay, but the money was good, and this one strategy took me from making about $35,000 per year all the way up to $85,000 per year. Now let's talk about the average pricing for my projects, and then we'll go into where the huge jump from $10,000 months to $50,000 in one month came from. My average projects when I first started might be $400 to $600. And it was mostly because I didn't know what I was doing. I was working with people who were going after bottom of the barrel pricing, and I resorted to websites like Upwork, Thumbtack, and Craigslist to get more work. Side note, there's nothing wrong with using these to get started or to gain new projects from time to time. They just shouldn't be your primary source of income if you want to make a living. As time went on, our average project jumped to about $1,500 to $2,500, with the occasional bigger 5 to 7K project here and there. It was a welcome jump, and I found that when clients were more invested, they were way less of a pain in the butt. For the crazy 50K month though, our average price per project was sitting nicely around $5,000 to $7,000, and we took on approximately 8 projects. The kicker is what attributed to the huge jump. We all know that COVID happened. I'm not going to dive into that, but the one thing that we couldn't have prepared ourselves for was how much COVID made us need live streaming. The month was May of 2021, and all of the colleges, private schools, and even public schools found themselves in a predicament. While mask mandates were starting to get lifted, there were still restrictions in many states as to how many people could attend an event and how they could be spaced out. This is where live streaming graduations exploded overnight. But the reason why I don't think this is going anywhere is because when I think back to my own college graduation, I remember there being a limited number of tickets to the event, and we could only bring certain family members. What about step-parents, uncles, aunts, grandparents? Live streaming made these events more accessible than ever, and with the inclusion of sign language and interpreters, these events can now be viewed across the globe. I think this is going to be here to stay. So you're probably thinking, okay, let's talk about pricing and how I can price more. I've heard enough about your story, and clearly it worked well for you, Zeph, but what about me? I got you. There are two pricing methods that you will see used most frequently in the video production world. There's charging for time, and there's charging for value that you bring to the table. When you see people charge for time, you'll most likely find prices like $1,000. But when you charge for the value that you bring to the table, you'll see crazy numbers, sometimes as high as 20, 40, or even 100K just for a single project with a client, and they'll happily pay it if the value is there. The one big challenge that most people have when it comes to charging based on value is that they don't know how to best determine their value and what they bring to the table. They also don't know that they can bring a lot of value to the table because maybe they're new to the business or don't have a lot of confidence in their work. Let's first talk about determining value, and then we'll talk about what to do if you're new to the game. If you took everything that adds up to me, Zephan, you'd find that I had a 4-year degree in video that cost $100,000, if not more. You'll also find that I had years of experience after graduation running a video studio for a marketing firm. I've had my own company for 8 years and more. I own all of my own equipment. I pay for a $2 million insurance policy. I pay for my studio. I have a circle of contractors and experts, freelancers, that I trust, and my videos can drive results. My videos can generate more sales, more visibility, and more attention. It's hard to put a number on that, and you can see why. There's tons of value there. I also couldn't go into a gig and say that I know that when you use this video, you're going to make an additional $200,000 this year, because I have no real way to look into a crystal ball and quantify what I'll be able to achieve. Maybe if you have years worth of working in the same niche, you can say, I know that past clients have seen X amount, but all of my clients are different, so we really can't quantify it that way. So here's how I determine my value. I created a pricing structure that shows the client the value in what we are bringing to the production, or in other words, to the live stream. And then I use that to explain to them how this will get them the end result that they want. Using industry pricing in my area, I found that the better videographers were billing somewhere between $100 to $150 per hour on their projects for filming, and $75 to $120 per hour for editing. But as time went on, I realized that they were charging all of these other things, like for the equipment that they brought, for the additional people that they brought, travel time, meals, you name it. This is where you might be missing out on thousands of dollars. So every project from here on out, I bill $150 per hour to my clients for me being on site, and then an additional $125 per hour for each additional person. Now, $125 per hour would be an amazing price for a camera operator or a production assistant, but I found that in my area, most people would be lucky to get $40 to $60 per hour for these roles. So instantly, I am profiting by charging the clients more than what I'm paying out. While I might pocket $150 per hour for myself, I could potentially be pocketing an additional $65 per hour for every camera operator that's with me. If there are three additional hands, I'll be making $345 per hour on a project. Do you see where this is going? I'm able to justify my value by coming with a trusted and insured team. As time goes on, that value will only increase because we will get better and the results that we drive for people will get better. That's where our pricing can go up. This brings me to point number two. What do you do if you're new? I always go back to my coach and think about what she told me about doubling my prices. If you're new, here's what you can do. First, you can learn. You must absolutely learn everything there is to know, and don't just learn about making good-looking videos. Learn how to tell a story. Telling stories is how you can create a video that will drive results, which is ultimately what the client is looking for. The second thing that you can do is work on building your confidence. If your voice gets shaky when you tell a client your price, you need to work on your delivery. If I went to order a pizza and the person at the cash register says, okay, I think it's gonna be $12.99, but it should be $12.99. What does that say to you, the customer? You'll probably ask if they're sure or if there's a different option that you're not thinking of. You need to work on confidently delivering the price to a client. Hi Greg, this project is going to cost $6,000, and that's to include three camera operators for the live stream, as well as myself as your live stream director. We'll show up 3 hours early to make sure the stage is set and to do some test runs and dry rehearsals so you can feel comfortable on stage. Sound good? You hear how confident that was? I was sure of my pricing, I explained what the client would get at that price, and I eased any fear that they might have. The third thing that you can do is apprentice or learn under others that are already doing this and have been doing so for quite some time. Now, I want to talk about how I blend the idea of charging for value versus charging for time. When I'm quoting a production, I typically plan for the labor that's involved based on time. I'll charge $150 for a live stream director, $125 for a camera operator, and $90 for a production assistant. These prices fluctuate depending on the project, but there's some rough prices that you can incorporate if you're bringing in a team and working at the same scale as I am. So let's take a sample live stream for a high school graduation as an example. This live stream is a 2-hour event and will require three camera operators and one unmanned wide angle camera. It will also need a live stream director. So in this case, I would bill $150 per hour for the director and $125 per hour for each of the camera operators for a total of $525 per hour from arrival to departure. This includes 3 hours of setup and rehearsal time, 2 hours of the event, and 1 hour of packing up and loadout. At 6 hours, that's a total of $3,150. Then we've developed a pricing structure for all of the equipment that we bring, so each item has a cost. Our live stream switcher is $300 for the day. Our teleprompter is $150 per day. To bring a camera with a tripod is $75 per day. If it's unmanned, we might bill $50 per day. We break these down when estimating, but we do not show the client each individual price. Otherwise, they'll start to nitpick the pricing. We'll simply line item this as equipment and list out our equipment needs with one total price. For most projects, especially live streams, there will be pre-production time like phone calls, planning meetings, creating some graphics, and the overall back and forth. We bill this at $100 per hour and tend to bill for 10 hours of pre-production and consultation time. So to recap, we have $1,000 in pre-production, $3,150 in labor or production charges, somewhere around $1,000 in equipment costs for a new total of $5,150. We haven't even included any editing or post-production work, travel time, and meals since it's a full day or anything else. Can you see how we can easily get to a $6,000 or $7,000 event with just one client? To give you a ballpark price to work on, I can say that on average our live streams have now been costing approximately $1,500 to $3,500 per finished hour of the live stream event, depending on how much is required. Hopefully that price and the method that I discussed above by separating out your costs for labor and equipment and additional fees will give you a small foundation on where to start charging for live streaming. If you're a beginner, you'll need to start somewhere. Pricing is complex and it evolves over time, but I can tell you right now that whatever price you're thinking of charging could easily be worth way more. Regardless of where you are on your journey, I challenge you to take your next live stream price and simply double it. Not because you're trying to rip the client off, but because chances are you are not charging enough to A, earn a living, B, pay out your team members a reasonable wage, and C, when you undercut your competition by that much, you are now locking in your place as the cheap provider, and it will make things infinitely harder for you in the future when you do need to earn more. There are so many more things that I could talk about pricing, and we actually have an opportunity for you if you're looking to work more closely with me on building out the last pricing system that you'll ever need for your projects. Together with my good friends Paul Xavier and Anthony Gallo, I've produced a 14-day video course called Six Figure Live Streamer. In this course, you'll get the opportunity to work directly with me to transform your filmmaking and videography business into a full-time live streaming business that not only pays the bills, but helps you get closer to the 10K, 20K, or even 50K a month that you'd only see in your dreams. There are tons of other filmmakers already going through our course that are finding massive value and are boosting their profits practically overnight. If you want to join them and see what all the excitement is about, head on over to contentcreator.com and look for the six-figure live streamer training. And if the course isn't right for you at this time, don't sweat it. We've got tons of free videos that we're putting out right here on this YouTube channel because my goal is to help 10,000 filmmakers and videographers grow their business by adding live streaming in the next 2 years. Be sure to hit the like and subscribe button below and stay tuned for all the juicy free content that we'll be releasing right here. Oh, and side note, I'm not going to hold back. You won't find me making those videos that flash a big shiny object in front of you like a carrot on a string that you can never grab. If you have questions, I want to answer them. If you're struggling, let me know in the comments and I'll do everything I can to give you some actionable tips. I'm here to help spread the wealth. Capiche? See you soon.